of the rural areas done by the urban industries. And nothing is so solidly done. And how we can create, there are a lot of commissions. Commission means there are two meanings, you know that. So commissions like Dr. Alak Commission, then M.S. Swaminathan Commission, Sen Gupta Commission, innumerable commissions they have made. And these commissions, they have given a lot of reports that now we are having lot of unreleased agro credits. Among 1 lakh crores of wealth, 60,400 is given to the industrial development. Only 10,400 has been, 11,000 is allotted to the agricultural development. So they have given three principles. Number one, immediately to release the fullest agro credit available to all people. Second thing, there is a small affected group, vulnerable group. They are known as marginal, small, medium farmers, MSMF. For these people, we have to refinance because otherwise they cannot develop. And for irrigation, storage, power systems, and for developing the transportation needed for their own agro industries, 25,000 crores that is stagnant with them is to be immediately released so that they can effectively do that this thing. These three things have been denoted even before 5 years, even before 1 year, even before 2 months, and no commission, all commissions have been put into omissions and it was not properly heard. And coming to my subject, psychobotany, we have to deal with the plants as living beings. It is known as Uttama Janma. Yesterday I told something about plants. It is known as Uttama Janma. Those who had done the virtue as well as the sin. It is a composite reflection of sin and virtue, punya and papa. There is a human being, that's what I told in one seminar of karma. There is a human being and as per his special nature, he is advanced as a human being. As a human being, even though he is great, he will be suffering like a dog. So his standard of living, that is living standard and special standard. So he has done some punya, some virtue, primary virtue, which has destined his body to be human. He has done some, he has made some sin, which has destined his standard of living. The special standard is determined by a primary or dominant virtue and a submissive or subservient sin that has rooted or framed the structure of standard of living, which is very pathetic and which is very deplorable. So there are dogs comfortable than human beings in the embrace of so many great media icons, politicians and other so-called worshipable celebrities of the community. So we are having all of these people. Like that, even if a person is sinful, suffering in spite of being human, that is virtue based on sin. If there is a tulsi, no doubt, as it is thavara, as it is a botanical species, it may be or it is inferior to human standards. But it is being worshipped by all people. Cow is worshipped, bilwa is worshipped. So even though they are infraspecial in nature, their standard or their way of respect that they claim as per the shastras and beliefs of the people that prove that they are supernatural. They are extra or exorbitant from the nature of the special limitations. Likewise, plants are specially blessed entities. Those people, those who worked for the society, those who wanted to work for the society, those who have done also a pinch of unintentional or unknown sin, they are born as plants and serve others. And their quality of being plants is determined by their unintentional cyclic bondage of few sins, as well as their service to the society is based on their intentional charity or the inbuilt magnanimity that they had executed in the previous birth. That's why we should say it is known as Nishkrishtotkrishta Janma. It is Nishkrishta by means of its special standard, Utkrishta by means of its productivity. That's why we should say Nirvikara, Paropakara, Sthira, Poshaka, Jagatadhara, Barada. These are all the names of stavaras. What is Nirvikara? If some insect or any other organic, there are three matters. One is material or chemical matter, and second thing is vegetative matter, third thing is organic matter. Whenever you see any other life form like insect or any other animal or bird that is collapsed, immediately you will feel something vijugupsa, which you call vijugupsa. We will feel obnoxious. But whenever a plant is collapsed, it is nirvikara. It has no vikara at all. Vegetative matter does not create any vikara. So that's why it is known as nirvikara. And second thing is paropakara. It can develop lot of things for the society. Yesterday I told, it gives temperature control to the world. It gives the global warming to be subsidized. It is a good cloud allurer and it takes the carbon dioxide and produces oxygen by balancing the alternative ways of survival between Stavara and Jangama community in the world. I have told everything, etc. It is a Poshaka, it is a Varada, everything, etc. So it has a feeling. It does not mean that somebody, there are two extremities. One is extreme cruelty, or it becomes otherwise a whimsical or a fanciful methodology of compassion. Even the compassion is there, that becomes very whimsical and fanciful. And treatment of cruelty means extreme cruelty. So there are two extremities. And somebody asks, if all plants are having lives, then we are stepping on grasses, we are stepping on ants. It is too much. So that which is intentional, that which is non-processive, and that which is accidental, that which is unavoidable, these things are entirely different from intentional act having some sort of malice and avarice. Malice and avarice is entirely different from actions of unavoidability and unintentional status of the processing of evolution or livelihood in the society. So we have to classify these two things. Like a Buddhist, we cannot be just cleaning the all the way where we are just moving in the earth. We cannot do that. So plants, there are worshipable plants. The Shastras say, if plants are having feelings, they are having life, they are having pain and pleasure, they are having attraction, repulsion, we are eating plants. So no doubt we have to kill the plants. And we are getting a lot of things through the plants. How it is possible? What is the ethical definition for that? There is a very wonderful definition given in the Shastras. Number one, Pratinidhya. What is known as? Pratinidhya. Second thing is known as Prayashchitya. Third thing is known as Prakriya. This Prakriya is very much known. You take to the amount you want, you take to the specific amount you want, number one, that is Parimiti. Second thing, you take that particular part you want, Avicheda. You take that particular amount you want, don't exploit it much, so that it grows or it processes by its own. Even lot of people are there, they will cut to the stem level and they will take something. So, Vicheda and Avicheda, Aparimita and Parimita, that differentiate between proper use and exploitation. So take the amount you want, take the particular portion you want, this is known as Prakriya. Prayashchita means daily we used to pray to God that intentionally or unintentionally, for the sake of our survival, even though that is a divine will, we have to qualify ourselves for taking that product from earth. That is a very wonderful thing. It is known as qualifying one's own self for survival. We have taken water from the world. The Vedic way of life is entirely different. We have taken some water from the earth and we are using it. And without using the water, there are two things. Without using the water, you cannot survive. The existence of water itself is for your purpose. So certainly you have to take that. It has been created for you. And you cannot be without that. So there is a natural binding. Why we have to do worship? Because you must qualify. That is qualified to contribute something to you. Apart from mere qualification, for example, in cinema I have heard a dialogue. What qualification you are having to marry my daughter? I am a male. That is the answer. Is it the only qualification required for a marriage? So, the ability to give nutrition is the qualification for the plants. But mere ability to use the nutrition is not your qualification. That is a female, there is a male. It is not the immediate qualification. Capability to take care of the bride is the qualification. Dignity to preserve, ability to preserve social dignity and domestic dignity is the advance or the additive qualification expected from the bridegroom. Likewise, it can give benefit, what you can work for him. Yes, if he gives money, I will take. If he feeds, I will eat. This is not the qualification. So apart from getting from the nature, being a proper representative by means of an ethical person in usage, distribution, conservation, preservation, and multiplication for the future generations, these five activities that gives you proper qualifier. If you take like that, it is bestowal. If you don't take like that, it is betrayal to the nature. So what we want? Not bestowal, betrayal. So, unless you can develop plant genetics and any other sciences, any other advanced sciences, you can go to the pro-genes or even sub-gene level. But without understanding the most subtlety of the ethical balance of the society, unless you qualify in governing a plant, number one, in giving it to all, number two, making it available for the others in the future also, number three, fourth thing, while doing these things without disturbing the eco setup, these four qualifications, if it is not there, then certainly it is a betrayal. So, mind, morale, music and mantra are the four forces with which we can mix with nature. Mind, with real mind, placid mind, tranquil mind, with reflecting natural, unalloyed mental ability, one can approach the plants. Second thing is morale, the principle and way of life. you know that Jacob.